Hi guys, welcome back to today's chargerLAB. Several days ago, we published a teardown video about Tesla's charging module of USB-C ports. If you haven't seen it, you can click the upper right corner to take a look. Today, we're going to move to the wireless charging area above the center console. You can charge two devices at the same time, each output is 7.5 watts, and the total output is 15 watts. In this case, you do not need to find the cable and plug it into the port, just put it directly and you're good to go, very convenient. Some features of USB-C are missing because of the chip shortage. What about the wireless charging module? Let's take a look. We can see the front of the module is covered with suede, which is non-slip and comfortable. The charging area is large enough to charge two devices simultaneously. Turn the back, there is a large metal plate for heat dissipation, which is fixed by three hexagon screws and four clips. The info shows its model is WC3. It supports input of 13.5 volts, 4 amp, and maximum output is 15 watts. It's also qualified to different standards, such as Qi standard. Firstly, remove all the screws. The plastic plate is made of fire-retardant PC and ABS, and here is some information. The other side is covered with fiber board, and the front and back of fiber board are covered by copper foil with black coating. The fiber board is fixed with 10 steel columns, so it's very stable. Remove the fiber board, I'm sorry, get the wrong tool. Turn the back and take a closer look. The wireless charging area adopts a grid design to improve heat dissipation efficiency. Next, we can see the charging coil below, and the upper PCB is also covered with a metal sheet. Each part has two coils, increasing the charging area to be compatible with different devices. Remove the last metal sheet. The PCB is fixed with screws, and the solder joints of the coil are on the back of the PCB. Try to remove the PCB. There are lots of thermal adhesives to dissipate heat for main components, and the metal plate can evenly and quickly dissipate heat. Then let's introduce all the components. The protocol controller comes from NXP-TJA-1021, which can work with master control chip to control the wireless charging and reduce energy consumption. And this is bidirectional high-precision current sense amplifier, which comes from Texas Instruments and is used for input current detection. The master control chip comes from NXP-MWCT-1213-AVLH. It can support wide range input of 5 to 24 volts and Qi 1.2.4 standard. And the maximum output power is 15 watts. Those are passive crystal oscillator and some external components. There are four half-bridge drivers, which come from diodes DGD-05473 and are used to drive the MOSFETs. There are two independent buck boost circuits and corresponding full-bridge MOSFET for wireless charging on the front of the PCB, as well as switching MOSFET of two coils. This is input protection MOSFET from diodes. Two electrolytic capacitors are connected in parallel, with center voltage is 35 volts. There are a total of 14 identical capacitors on the PCB. Those two switching MOSFETs come from diodes TH6016LPDQ used to switch between two coils, 60 volts, 19 milliohm. There are 8 identical MOSFETs used for dual output of wireless charging. Model is diodes DMT47M2SFVWQ, 40 volts, 7.5 milliohm. And then, here are 5 white MPO resonant capacitors. This is Texas Instruments Ultra Small Synchronous Buck Converter, which supports input voltage of 42 volts. And the adjustable output regulator can power the mass control chip, which comes from Texas Instruments TPS7A8101. And this little chip is a dual operational amplifier. This is the synchronous buck boost converter used for voltage conversion of wireless charging. Model is MPS-MPQ-4231. Well, that's all components of this wireless charging module. After taking apart, we found the most impressive part is the heat dissipation structure. It can adopt a large heat sink without considering the weight and have enough space to enhance heat dissipation performance. And the rest of the components also come from well-known brands such as NXP, DIODES, MPS, and Texas Instruments. So the overall quality is pretty good. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to view related videos. Don't forget to subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!